What is going on, guys? We're back with some more Lucha Underground review. This episode is 6/8/16, and Pentagon Jr. is back. But that's at the end of the show. The beginning of the show, we saw Marty the Moth, Martinez. Him and Mil Mortez are the only two people in Lucha Underground that I do not like, and that's saying a lot since they have a freaking huge roster. So, and he faces Killshot. They don't even get the match. Don't even start. The match basically does start. The refs count to 10. He restarts. He restarts because they're so lenient in Lucha Underground. And finally, he has no other choice but to count them out. And basically, Marty the Moth took Killshot's dog tags, and Killshot tried to rip his hair out. Like he grabbed dog tags and tries to escape from out of the ring. And so Killshot grabs him, but the only way he can grab him from without him actually fully escaping the ring was by his hair. And so he's got his foot on the rope pulling his hair, and Marty the Moth just, like, a couple seconds later pulls himself off. I'm like, you're gonna get your head ripped off, dude. What the fuck? That was insane. What are you doing? What are you doing? Woo! We had a cutscene. Hold on, I don't know why I keep calling these cutscenes. We're playing 2K, but, it was with Cortez, Mr. Cisco, and Joey Ryan, and that cop chick, and basically interrogating Cisco. Not too much to note from that. I don't really know how I feel about this part of the show. In all honesty, I've actually been alright with the promos and stuff they do in the back. I think it's pretty cool, but some of them could be done better, but you get what you get. But it's a really great show, so I think all in all, it's fine, to be honest. And now the next match, I swear to you, was the best idea and coolest idea for a match I've ever heard in my fucking life. And I'm honestly not lying here. A fucking nunchuck match? Are you fucking kidding? Woo! Let me just say that. Like, I swear, they beat the shit out of each other. So, they didn't, for some reason, they used ladders to get the nunchucks. Which was kind of weird. Like, it was Jack Evans and PJ Black versus Dragon, Aerostar, and Drago. And, oh my god. Jack Evans got on PJ Black's shoulders and trying to reach for it, but he still wasn't, you know, high enough. And here comes, and this is in the tunnel where the entrance is. And here comes Drago off the top of the fan's little railing thing and jumps off on him like, what were y'all doing trying to do that? So they fight up to the stairs, and this is where shit gets real. They get the nunchucks, Jack Evans and PJ Black too, and I swear they killed Drago and Aerostar. So they were just taking turns trying to one-up each other. And Jack Evans won when he goes, watch this Michelangelo. And he's doing some Michelangelo like from Ninja Turtles and shit, and hits him with it. But finally, Drago gets away, and Justin Gabriel goes after Drago, and they fight on to the fans, and then Drago gets the nunchucks, and it hits them in the face, and on top of the head. They're trying to fight up to the platform. Drago one to the head to PJ Black, one freaking right to the face to Jack Evans. I'm like, oh my gosh, whew. They ain't gonna knot on the top of their heads after that match, but so then Aerostar and Jack Evans fight onto the other side of the platform, which is on top of Dario Cueto's office. Oh my god. So Jack Evans, like, jumps from one fence to the other fence, little garbled things, on the Aerostar. He grabs the nunchucks, gets over to the top of the thing, and then there's Aerostar. He pushes him. He's holding on like a bite. His fingertips trying to hold on. Stay on top, right? And Aerostar is trying to hit him with nunchucks. He finally just falls off onto PJ Black. And Aerostar jumps from off of the office onto those guys. And the fans, the believers, they're freaking going absolutely apeshit. I mean, I was too, to be honest. That was pretty freaking awesome. Every time, and Helico does it, I go pretty freaking insanely just crazed as well. Pretty insane. So finally, Jack Evans and Drago fight on into the ring. Sorry about that. And keep this in mind, Jack Evans is the Dragon Slayer, and he's a fucking Dragon Slayer, man. one of my favorites in Lucha Underground. He's so arrogant. And I like the people that scream and talk shit during the match, like Bully Ray and Jack Evans. Perfected it. They're great. They're awesome. But Drago hits the dude in the face, on top of the head, on the chest, then on the, hits him up into the jaw with a nunchuck. People, it's a crazy ass, just knocks him the fuck out. His spirals, lands on the apron. Drago hits the pin, and it was over. And he's not the Dragon Slayer anymore, damn it. Come on. Damn it. They're still awesome. They're still Trios Champions with Johnny Mundo. I really don't care. They're the best. Now our main event. Oh, God. Our main event was awesome as hell. It was a... Okay, let's see. Let's see if I can get this right. Ivelisse, Taya, Johnny Mundo, Phoenix, Queen Cuerno, and Chavo. Wait. No, it was not Chavo, because freaking here comes Mr. Cerro. I can't say that word. Not that I can't speak Spanish. I failed Spanish class. But yeah, no fear. Pentagon Jr. comes out with the coolest mask ever. Blood, like, whatever. It was freaking awesome. But he breaks Chavo's arm. Bye-bye, Chavo. I actually want to see Chavo versus Rey, because Rey was on the other team, along with the Mag Sexy Star, Prince Puma. There's one more. So many fucking people in this match. So many. And Son of Havoc, I mean, I don't know. There's so many people, dude. And they were hitting the insane amount of flips, dude. Like, to be there live. I lost my voice for the next 3 days. That's how much screaming I had done during the match. Oh my gosh. I was doing screaming here. I mean, in my chair watching this shit, I was screaming. But, King Cuerno. That move he does where he shoots the bow and arrow, dives out of the ring, and he did, and he dove right onto the crowd on the, I think it was Pentagon, not Pentagon, they're on the same team. Wow, what am I talking about? I think it was a Mac or whatever. Right onto the freaking crowd. I'm like, let's go, let me be in the front row. And let me be in the front row, that'd be awesome. Probably hurt a little bit, but let me be in the front row to experience that, just throw a lifetime, something cool like that. I really would enjoy that, but they're still hitting flips. And just, I think after this match, I would like to see some freaking dream matches. Pentagon Jr. Rey Mysterio for one. King Cuerno Rey Mysterio. King Cuerno Rey Mysterio. Yes, please. Yes, please. Oh, Tejano was in this match too. Like I said, there's so many people. But Tejano was fighting Johnny Mundo. He sets Johnny Mundo on the top rope. And here comes the Taya, and he's trying to hit Tejano. Tejano's like, no, you ain't hitting me. And he rams her face in the Johnny Mundo's yam bags. Ouch. Ouch. So, I mean, but it don't really matter. Johnny Mundo gets out of it and hits that insane move off the top rope with a flip. I don't know what that move's called. I've seen a lot of people use it. It's just so awesome when it happens. You're just like, oh my God. And Rey Mysterio hit the 619, and it wasn't even over after that. I was like, are you serious? Like, the match was cool. If you've never seen Lucha Underground, this should have been the night you watched it. Nunchuck match. That insanely epic tag team match at the end. You've got to go check it out if you've never seen it. My favorite match of the night, still the nunchuck match. That was purely awesome. And Jack Evans is just awesome as hell. Like I said, the tag team match was good. Fucking Pentagon Jr.'s back. Oh, and Phoenix was on the other team, too. So many wrestlers. So many. But next week, since these guys won, they'll be facing each other. So next week, Pentagon Jr., Johnny Mundo, Taya, Ivelisse, Phoenix. Well, I'm already forgetting some, dude. It's insane. Like I said, there's so many. King Cuerno. And then there's another, and I missed it. Sorry about the guys. There's so freaking many of them. And that'll be in the main event next week to see who goes on to Ultima Lucha Dos. And I say, I had a list there. What the fuck happened? I say Pentagon Jr. wins it. Next week, Pentagon Jr. wins it. He's on a path. And no one will stop him on that path to Matanza. And yes, I would love to see that match again. But like I said, this week's episode was pure just fun to watch. Like, subscribe, and comment. Tomorrow we got a couple videos to upload. Should be interesting. Stay tuned, and I am out. Thanks for watching.